morning, everyone. I am Ning. This is Shen and Fiona. We come from the National University of Singapore, and we are very honored to be here today to present our case study on Banyan Tree Holdings. Banyan Tree Holdings is a leading global hospitality brand that develops and manages premier resorts, hotels, residences, and spas. Its headquarters are located in Singapore, and it has come a very long way from its initial beginnings as a single boutique resort in Phuket in 1994. Today, there are 36 resorts and hotels, 73 spas, and 91 retail galleries in 28 countries under the group's management. Far from Banyan Tree's current success, its beginning was fraught with challenges. First, the founders purchased a plot of land, which was an abandoned tea mine on the western coast of Phuket. They thought it was an ideal location to build a resort on. However, they only found out later that the land was certified as being too toxic to support vegetation or to develop on. Hence, the founders kickstarted an extensive cleanup of the area that cost $250 million, from filling in the old mine to reintroducing indigenous plants. But challenges still persisted. After they had built hotels on the land, they experienced difficulty leasing out their fifth hotel due to a lack of a beachfront, which was deemed unattractive. So the founders decided to set up their own resort and serve up their own vision of Asian hospitality, and eventually they found success. Banyan Tree's success can be primarily attributed to its branding strategies. From the beginning, the founder, Mr. Ho Kwang Ping, had asserted the necessity of building a strong global brand name. A brand gives one a proprietary advantage, which allows one to be sustainable without having to try to compete with its competitors. This was especially pertinent because there were cheaper competitors in the industry coming from Indonesia and China. So how was Banyan Tree able to create a strong global brand name for itself? It was because of its unique private pool villa concept that sets it apart from its competitors. Marketed as a sanctuary for the senses, Banyan Tree promises to offer guests romantic and intimate experiences. To fulfill this brand promise, Banyan Tree considers all aspects of its physical settings, such as location, facilities, and ambiance. For example, exotic locations with exclusive access to sunbathed beaches were deliberately chosen to offer guests romantic and intimate experience habitats. Unlike other hotels with communal facilities, each villa at Banyan Tree Resorts comes with a private pool, jacuzzi, or spa treatment room, providing guests with utmost privacy. Also, catering to couples on a romantic getaway, Banyan Tree offers an intimate women's package to set the ambiance appropriately with sprinkled petals and scented candles in the room. Another area that Banyan Tree stands out in is in how it pays homage to Asian traditions and heritage. Each resort has its own special local twist, reflected in the architecture of the place that draws inspiration from the local culture. The management also encourages employees to infuse local practices into the service delivery process. For example, in Phuket, a couple can appreciate Thai music played by private Thai musicians while serving their dinner on a traditional Thai longtail boat, whereas in Maldives, wedding ceremonies can be conducted underwater among the corals. Now Shen will continue with other aspects of the branding strategies.
Thank you, Tine. So Banyan Tree's brand communication strategy is also a reason for a strong brand name. Based on public relations instead of advertising, this can also help to save costs. The media coverage has helped Banyan Tree to build strong international awareness and credibility. To Mr. Ho, advertising is self-praise, so the customers will treat them with suspicion. Banyan Tree was founded with a core value of social responsibility, a desire for sustainable development, as well as a long-term view for the future. Banyan Tree's triple bottom line of economy, environment, and society enables it to become a company that is socially responsible through empowering the people and embracing the environment. Such practices include the Banyan Tree Gallery, which was launched in 2000 to provide gainful employment to local artisans who supply handmade crafts in retail outlets. So, back by the success of Bayan Tree Expansion by Zilling earlier, there has been two new branches of brand extensions, Angsana and Cassia, which targets a different customer segment based on different price points. However, the challenges for Bayan Tree is not over yet. In the recent decade, Bayan Tree has faced financial crises as well as health scares and natural disasters. In 2003, the SARS outbreak taught Bayan Tree how vulnerable the tourism industry was, and the following year, things were looking bad for Bayan Tree, whose properties were dotted across the Indian Ocean. Occupancy rates dropped because nobody came due to the tsunami. And the hotel operation profits dropped to 23.5% of the total operating profits. In 2008, the financial crisis actually led to shrinking of market strongholds like France and Germany, leading to fewer bookings. And most recently, the MERS saga could also become a trap for Bayan Tree. So what can Bayan Tree do about that? Besides relying on branding to indirectly help them tide over crises, Bayan Tree also has contingency strategies directed at each crisis. Firstly, Bayan Tree diversifies, so that in case of instances such as the tsunami, it will not be all affected. Bayan Tree can also diversify into new locations such as Italy and Spain. Another example was during the SARS crisis, where there was a no-pay leave scheme implemented so that normal business operations could not be affected. And last but not least is financial management. So under financial management, Bayan Tree will leverage on funds it receives so that it can tide through financial crises and also cash flow decisions. So when necessary, Bayan Tree will actually minimize the capital expenditure and defer projects that have yet to commence. Bayan Tree has a good cash flow management due to its strategy of preserving cash. Bayan Tree also actively seeks out investors and the help of investment bankers to help them raise funds, and this is so that they can have ability to tide through the financial lows and also to expand the business at the same time. And in 2007, Bayan Tree's own hospitality fund was set up to tap on private equity, and this is to provide a cost-efficient structure to fund future developments. And now I'll pass the time on to Fiona.
Thank you, Shen. I'll now go on to the current strategies such as the key success factors, the current challenges, as well as our recommendations for future direction. So the first key success factor for Bayan Tree lies in the nature of going slow to go fast. Going slow entails computing a significant amount of resources in conducting market research to determine the unique features that are needed in each of the target markets. This is in line with the aim of amalgamating the results of the research into the new properties effectively, such that they can then grow fast. The second key success factor for Bayan Tree stems from the tropical gardens park pavilion, which is funded by Mr. Ho and his creative team. So Mr. Ho actually used the Western concept of spa as his basis by converting its clinical wide-accepted environments into an open-air pavilion that is surrounded by large tropical greenery. The plain white costumes of the therapists were also replaced with vibrant ethnic costumes, and this concept actually led to astounding results, such as many other companies even began to adopt this same similar concept. And even so, Bayan Tree Spa would eventually establish as a separate entity from the resort business. With regards to current challenges, Bayan Tree's first challenge lies in the difficulty in striking a balance between remaining unification and developing its image to fit a more global arena. So Mr. Ho actually sets his dilemma of placing a resort in Morocco, with other customers who actually be attracted to a Thai resort in Morocco, or would they come because they know that Bayan Tree will bring about certain attributes, service standards and service cultures, such that they can then experience the best of Morocco in Morocco. As such, Bayan Tree's strategies will work. Secondly, the consequences of brand extensions are really far-reaching, in that Bayan Tree has found a challenge in managing it. So as there has been an increase in the number of product lines, business lines, target groups and price segments, Bayan Tree has found that there was a need for them to balance each of these individual businesses, such that it will prevent the dilution of the more dominant Bayan Tree brand. This is so since the lower-end Angsana and Cashier brand actually exudes a similar vibe compared to the higher-end Bayan Tree brand. Going on to the recommendations for our future direction, we've come about with a few strategies that would help to counter the previous challenges that were mentioned. Firstly, Mr. Ho believes that businesses play should be localized as much as possible, but the unique spa concept and the Asian ambiance should still be retained. Lastly, to target brand dilution, we recommend that